Welcome everyone to another episode of the Chesterfield Career Mode. After a chaotic, hectic, just crazy last couple of months, we're kind of at that point in the season where it's just play some games, manage the squad, keep everyone happy. And that's what we're going to be doing in today's episode. Just going to kind of go through some stuff. We will be playing this game against Salford City here on the 21st for this month of September. But I'm also going to make a change to the team. Tactics-wise, last game we had a whole lot of success, abandoning our little custom role, and just going wing play. Because you look at our team, we have very, very good midfield. Let's take advantage of that. We have a good midfield coach. You see gold on all these guys. So that's what we'll be kind of switching things up as we head forward. Why did I not save? Formation, we're going to stay with our 4-2-3-1. Alright, it says to stay wide. I love it. Player roles. I liked how everything was going. Obviously, Will Grigg is a target forward. Always love that. Attacking wingbacks, though. Absolutely love to see this out of them, because we scored our game winner, because Gordon made a run from left back up behind their defensive line, so gotta keep that heading forward. Yes, I would like to save the changes. And I'm pretty sure Youth Academy Scout will be returning tomorrow. So we'll probably get to look at some more Zimbabwean players. Offers. Yeah, I'm only taking offers for Daily Campbell, so sorry. New email from League 2. Half a million spent in the summer transfer window. That's kind of crazy. I don't have enough players to participate in Youth Academy tournaments. Yeah, I don't really care. Alright, let's check out what our scout has brought us back. So far, he's brought back two starting players for our team, so... Well, you're going to be joining the team. You will as well. Keep an eye out on you. But yeah, you'll never make it. We'll be generous and we'll keep an eye on you guys. Now let's check out these players. 61 overall Zuka Zoo. 5-star weak foot incredible passer. Hold on, wait a minute. Make him an attacking midfielder. Ooh, I'm liking what I'm seeing. The vision I'm painting in my head is a beautiful one. Oh, I gotta make some changes. Now, if you don't know much, and I really haven't shown this side of when I do these career modes, this kind of constant changing kind of happens all the time. Like, Zoo, welcome to the team. You know, just last episode, I said, I'm going to be doing this. I'll be changing this. I'll be changing that. Mark and Day. Bench. Zoo. Starting attacking midfielder. Vera, we're going to keep on the right because I want him to kind of be an inverted type of winger. Yeah, save the changes. Now we got to go edit our development plans. Because I just switched everyone around. Kind of in that midfield three. Now I have to undo everything. So showing great potential, that will obviously be insanely boosted by dynamic potential. But Vera, you're no longer going to be an attacking midfielder. You're going to be a right mid. He's got the good finishing, so cutting inside will be no problem for him. All right, I think that's the only big change we'll make. I don't think my England scout's going to necessarily bring us back anybody too crazy. I think we should go ahead sim ahead to this Chris. A message from Zoo. Are you just thanking me? Yeah. You know, I love it. I love it, Zoo. You'll be amazing for us soon. It'll just take a little while for us to get there. But I mean that's kind of what happens with all these players. So you know, like, it's whatever. New position for McDowell. Officially an attacking midfielder. Love to see that. Yeah, I'm going to sim this game against Carlisle. results. 3-1 loss. Okay. But, I mean, we did just bring in a younger player. Overall, we'll dip a little bit. I expect that we got... I know the sim does not like when you have players out of position. Our left mid, right mid, and attacking mid are all playing out of position, so probably won't get the most favorable sim results from that. Press conference? Ooh, is this a rivalry? Tantan, he's doing just fine. Why? Bro, why are we grilling Tantan right now? Fleck is literally the heartbeat that makes this team happen. Without Fleck, the midfield would be atrocious. Go ahead, sim this game. 3-1 victory. Alright, we're back. Fleck, Vera, Grig. Alright, we're officially back. Had a little blooper there against Carlisle. Ooh. Next up is this game against Salford. Ooh, new positions available for 3 players. Yeah, I will definitely be making those changes before we get into this game. Banks, Vera, and Zoo. Love to see that. Alright, Banks. Yep, to a CDM. Now, you look at the stats, you think attacking mid, but my attacking mid has to have pace, and he has 0 pace. Zoo, officially an attacking midfielder. Now, do I want to mess with this at all? Because I don't think Shadow Striker is what I want. Holding, no. Advanced Playmaker. I think I'm just going to kind of leave him alone. Just kind of naturally develop for now. He does already have a 5-star weak foot, so I don't need to do that. So I think we'll leave that there. Wasn't there supposed to be 3 position changes, not just the 2? Ah, Youth Academy. Gunner's now right mid. Love to see that. Alright, let's take a look at this Salford team. So they're also playing a 4-2-3-1. Luke Garbutt at left back. What's he rated these days? They're in horrible form. Young off the bench, I know who that is. So their midfield's very good, that's what I'm learning from this. Well, fantastic. This is gonna be a rough game. This is gonna be an interesting game, but hey. You look at this team, we're young, we're promising, we got some flair in us. Let's just go out and win this game. Actually, let's change the uniforms up, because we've played too many... Actually, it has to stay. Alright, this is our third game now straight. 3 games played, 3 games of blue jerseys versus red jerseys. But with that, enough being said, ladies and gentlemen, here are the highlights. Step up, Dunkley. Oh, no. Jeez, what a shot. Oh, good. They just took off one of their midfielders, I think. How is he scoring from that angle? And how did Fleck not get... a limb in the way. Bro, their manager's the basic manager. Bro, it's the default manager. Thompson, I think that one might have been on you. Like, Fleck, get your body in the way there. I think that should have been saved by the keeper. Just my opinion. Lock on. Jeez, bro. Gordon, how do you not get that ball? We're quite literally on top of him. Good flick on there by Vera. Yes, Zoo. Go, Zoo. You're faster than him. Yes, Zoo. Come on, Zoo. On your debut. On his debut. Gets the equalizing goal. Excellent hold-up play from Grig again. I mean, Greg's going to end up our leading assister this year because he can just hold that ball up and just play it through to anybody. Well, he can help play it through. You know what I mean. But that is now, we have two players who have debuted, two goals from those players in their career. And hey, it doesn't have to be a good finish. It has to go in the back of the net. And that's what it did. And we're all tied up at one. Technically didn't lose possession of the ball. Oy! Get there, Fleck. Please, Fleck. Jeez. All right, Edwards, what you got? Nothing. Nothing. Vera's going to shift over. Yes, Vera. Look at that. That is how you get out of that situation. Let's give it to Grigg. You can hold it up. Gordon now. No help. No help whatsoever. Make that run, Tierney. Keep going. Keep it going. Keep it going, Tierney. Tierney! What a goal! Coming up from the defensive mid position, scoring a beautiful goal. Man, okay. So if I've learned anything, we need to hold the ball up and play it through for these guys. Because we can get those deep-lying runs. I mean, look at that. Told him to go. Zoo, excellent job just holding it up, not forcing it. And Tierney gets himself his first goal of his career. And we're in a good spot. Now that we know this team, I'm feeling confident. We can beat anybody in the world. What an excellent win from the boys. Shaking the hands of default manager. Hey, we missed you, bro. We missed you. We miss you. But hey, we're winning games. They're not easy. They're not boring. But we are getting the wins. Another 2-1 victory. Another come-from-behind victory. And even more just kind of like understanding who we are as a team. You know, it took until the second half. Like, we're really starting to kind of find ourselves right now. We're in a really, really good groove. Like, you look at the match facts. You know, we're not going to dominate possession. It's not how we play. But we're just gonna go out there. We're going to try to score some goals. We'll possess when we need to. But hey, I'm also... Let's go. Let's go forward. All right, what you got for us? Tierney played... he got a goal. Yeah, we just gotta encourage him. Hey, keep doing what you've been doing, Tierney. You're the man still. Zoo, oh. What a debut. Like, an absolutely phenomenal debut. But Grigg is still an amazing striker for us. He does exactly what we need him to. Let's calm down on his slander, okay? Two unread messages. Was an easy decision. Maybe at some point in the future. I don't know if I have the finances to do that right now, Fleck. But I promise you, I want you to stay at our club. Role update. Ooh, go to youth scout reports. Our scouts came back. Not good. Hey, very good. Average will let him develop. You know, because Bartlett has 66 to 88 potential with 52 to 70 overall. I will promote him. Well, I'll sign him just to see how good he actually is. All right, Guatemalan keepers. Santiago Ortega, 14 years old. It's going to take some getting used to with that. All right, let's check out. Bro, my game is glitched. Alright, well, let's save and quit. And we'll load back in. Okay, let's save and quit. Load back in. And hopefully everything's still fixed and fine. Okay. So I know that if that happens, it's not the end of the world. Alright, so Vera doesn't look... Bentley still looks good. Barlett, we just signed, actually looks pretty decent. Zoo's not the greatest, neither are you. Gardner, good outside mid, I guess. McDonald, he's going to take some time. Park, a very attack-minded outside back, but I kind of want to let him stay that way. He is only 14 years old, a lot of time to develop. And same goes for Santiago Ortega. 14 years old, 5-star weak foot from a keeper. He's got footwork. Okay, he's going to be fun to play with in the future. Pause. All right, game against Colchester. I'm just going to sim that one. Who really cares? I have two C teams. I don't know if there's a rivalry. If there is, I apologize. But we already played our game for the month. 1-1 draw. Greg with the late winner. Love to see it. Because as much as, like, in the Premier League, it's so different than League 2, like, you can realistically just keep drawing games. And win every once in a while, you will still be in that area. So, I don't know what that just did, but he's got two pluses, so I assume he gets an additional boost from our coaching staff. Because that's also another thing we could look at upgrading our coaching staff. With a little bit extra money that we have. Where's Zoo? I swear he has a position change. Oh, he's in the youth academy. Nope. Okay. So I think we can just go ahead and sim to the end of this month. I don't think we really have anything left we need to do. Yeah. End of the month. Take a look at the table. So we're third. Currently in a playoff spot, but obviously we are still very young in the season. But Colchester either win or lose, that's kind of crazy. Alright, I like where we're at right now. Check out the calendar, see who are we gonna play, who's gonna be our game for this month of October. Ooh, wait, okay, never mind. I thought it was an FA Cup game potentially. I think we have to play Bromley. You know, a little just-got-promoted derby. It'll be early in the month. Can get right into the action. I think that's what we're going to do. Play against Bromley. I was originally going to go with Bromley, but then I saw their board objectives through a YouTuber that I watch, and they had one financial. I was like, okay, no. I need a club that's willing to just let me spend the money and just expects me to win. So, hey, it'll be a good little game. Nice little storyline. And Hopefully it's an easier game for us than our last couple of games have been. You know, kind of like that first game of the season. I would like a easier win, but same time, I don't mind these, you know, grinding out these 2-1 wins. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit that subscribe button, and I will see you all for that game against Bromley.